3.3 I'm going to do quicker than 3.2 because it is using the same format as 3.2's notes. So 3.3, the difference, and I mentioned this in the last section's video, will ask that you have to use the X and Y intercepts. So the directions will say, find the X and Y intercepts and graph the equation. I still recommend doing an extra point. And again, I have the two most important pieces up here as a reminder. But what I want you to do is kind of pause these. Hopefully you've printed out the handouts, and then you can pause it, see that you can do it, because I'm not showing all of the work for these pieces. So I'm going to just talk you through it. For the first problem here, we have 4x equals 3y minus 9. When we plug in for the x-intercept, which means plug in y equals 0, we get the point negative 2, 1 fourth, which, again, not is between negative 2 and negative 3. When I plug in x equals 0 for my y-intercept, I get 3y minus 9 equals 0. And when I solve that, I will get 0, 3 for my y-intercept. I did a checkpoint, at least one, plugged in 3, I plugged in 1, and got two other pieces. You need at least 2 points. This section, again, stress is enough, especially test time. You've got to double check yourself what the directions say. You will be marked wrong if you do not use the intercepts. So these 2 points have to be graphed in my math lab. Checkpoint, make sure that you did it correct. But if you use the checkpoint as a graph in this section, even if the graph is right, it's going to mark it wrong. So again, pause it. Go ahead and do number 2. X plus 2y equals 5. When we plug in x intercept, which is plugging in y equals, for my x intercept, we plug in y equals 0. I get x equals 5. So that's my first point, which is in blue. Y intercept plugs in x equals 0. When I plug in x equals 0, I get 2y equals 5. Divide both sides by 2, I get 5 halves, which is the same thing as 0, 2 halves. Because of the directions, those are the 2 points you have to use in my math lab. If it's a fraction, you plot close to it, or they may have the tick marks being different. So please look at the tick marks, plug it where you think it is, and then click edit for the point. So checkpoint here, I did plug in x equals 1 and plug in x equals 2, which are my orange points on there. So looking at number 3, go ahead and pause it. You should know that this is a special case. Y equals negative 6 has one variable. So that means the y equals is a y-intercept, which is 0, negative 6. Any other point you can plot as long as it has a negative 6 in the y value. Last one for 3.3 is again another special case that I kind of, even though it doesn't look like it, it has no constant term, so that's what I want you to recognize. We had this happen on one of the problems in 3.2. If there's no constant term, we will always get the x and y intercept being the same. The x and y intercept will be 0, 0. So that gets a lot of people on the test hung up because, again, you're going to have a special case where it's just x equals y equals on the test. Absolutely, you're going to have it because we deal with it in probably 4 sections at least. This type of special case probably will be there as well to see that you understand what to do. Now, later on, if you understand how to use slope, you could use that after you plot this 0, 0. The directions say plot the x and y intercepts, and this one only has one. So doing other checkpoints, which would have normally been a checkpoint, I plugged in x equals 1. That gave me a fraction, which I really didn't like to graph. But once I got that, I used the idea of 5 in the denominator. So I plugged in x equals 5, and I got the point 5, negative 3, which I could plot. That's the orange point here. This point here is what I have highlighted there in yellow. So these four problems really were just for y'all to double check you had the rules down. If you're still struggling, go back and listen to 3.2's lecture. I went into much more detail, showed all the steps of finding my X and Y intercepts. But there are last questions here just to double check that we know. So I want you to read them, pause it, read them, see if you can answer the questions before you listen to my answers. So number one says, can the same point ever be both the X and Y intercepts on the graph? My answer here should be yes. We just did an example where the origin is both my X and Y intercept. Number two, what is the maximum number of X intercepts a line will have, excluding my special case, which is Y equals zero? So if we look at all of my examples, if it's linear, there should be only one intercept, except for the special case. Will a line always have at least one y-intercept? This is a tricky one. Your answer should be no, because if we have our special case, which is, again, a x equals line, so I'm just going to draw you an example here real quick. This does not have a y-intercept, so special cases breaks that rule. What is the purpose of my arrowheads? When we're graphing this, we're only graphing two points, but it goes on infinitely, both directions. So there are infinite answers of points that actually work for this linear equation.